Just before we came on air, actually, I was speaking to some of the people that are gathered here. One gentleman who won't come on air was speaking to me, and he was saying, well, I've seen media from all over the world, Europe and the Middle East, but where's the BBC? And he was talking about the fact that there's pockets of protesters that have been cordoned off, as they have been here in the central location, right across the city. He said he's been walking around for about an hour, and basically it seems that these groups of protesters are being stopped from gathering in one location. Of course, that sounds like the cattling technique that we've seen in previous big demonstrations, for example, the student demonstrations. And that does seem to tie into what Julian Assange was saying and what some of the contacts that I have here are saying. In terms of numbers here, Rosha Mohamed Saleh, who has been reporting as well, he's saying that behind the cordon here, there are several thousand, about 3,000, he said. And we're hearing that elsewhere across the centre of London and across the city, there are other big groups gathering as well.
It seems like the standard operating procedure, Narges, based on what the coverage was on the Occupy Wall Streets, was to first see how it's going to pan out. They would touch on it. This is in the U.S. They would touch on it, round it up, not too much video. But then they realized, well, we need to catch up with this because it's gaining momentum, in which then further on down the line, the coverage was given. Unfortunately, it was because there were a number of arrests made, that big arrest made on the Brooklyn Bridge. So at this point, I'm curious how it's being covered there. I mean, are they just running it like a voiceover in their newscast, or is it getting somewhat of a coverage, or is it just not even being covered that much at all?
Well, I am here covering it as it happens for you, so I don't think I would be in the best position to see how the other news stations are covering it as we speak right now. That's certainly an interesting point, though, Kaveh. There was media here. I got here at about 10:30, 10:45 a.m. There were no protesters gathered, but the news media was here, and there are satellite trucks around. But you will find that many, many people here will be very wary of mainstream media, and they will say that, oh yes, they're here to cover it, but by what angle, and what are they going to say at the end of the day? So I think as the day moves forward and the evening news here in Britain goes out, then we'll know how it is being covered. There's always a lot of focus on London if there's protests here, so I'm sure that they will touch up on it. The mainstream media was picking up on this story before it happened. That is different to, for example, in the United States and the Wall Street, the Occupy Wall Street movement. It took very long for the mainstream media in the United States to pick up on the story. Even stations like CNN were criticized for not picking up on it sooner. And of course, some of the more controversial outlets very much criticized for the way that they portrayed the protesters. But still, today, many, many people out. It's still very peaceful. There's many young people, the families out, a real broad spectrum of people out here today.
Right.